So there's two in both orchestras, and then there's like six in each band.
You got this.
Where am I going?
So when you walk into the room, you'll see there's a music stand and a chair, and then you'll see this big black fabric screen. But you do not see the judges do not see you.
We're instructed to shut our mouths and not make any noise other than our playing.
It's intimidating because you hear voices that you haven't heard before telling you what to do.
And we play, then we leave.
In the same way that math doesn't really have a form, to me music also doesn't really have a form. It feels extra dimensional to me. It creates worlds in your brain, it creates emotions that you don't feel, but it makes you feel them.
We tend to like to streamline things in modern American society, to make everything fit in a box. That takes away all the edges, that takes away all the art. To me, that's what makes art interesting, is the ambiguity and the differences and the unevenness.
I had a bit of a legacy to fulfill, I would say, entering the School of Music due to my sister. She had been deeply involved in music, particularly within the symphony orchestra. It was sort of expected of me to enter the symphony cycle.
Playing music, it's such a personal thing, and the point of an audition is to basically judge you for your artistry and your like technical ability. It's naturally very nerve-wracking.
When playing violin, I just enter another world, communicating with the composer. In the warm-up room, I can just forget everything around me. But like when I'm in the audition, I just maybe got a little bit nervous.
And I think the most important thing to me as someone who's auditioning is just the ability to like let things go. My entering and learning how to play trumpet was fairly typical.
I started on piano in maybe like second or third grade.
I picked it up in fifth grade.
I mean, I was in choir too in elementary school.
I believe I started playing violin since I was 3 and a half.
In fourth grade, I played the cello.
When I was 5 or so, I just picked up the violin and the piano.
I played the flute for about a week, and then I was like, I don't want to hold this up anymore. I switched to clarinet.
I got my violin placement and wasn't happy with it, or my mom wasn't happy with it. I was auditioned on viola. Ever since then, I stuck with it.
And then I switched to bass clarinet.
My first instrument was clarinet. I started in second grade. I played for 6 years, and then I was intimidated by the other clarinet players going into high school.
And then I switched to bassoon.
I got into percussion at my freshman year of high school, and I have not looked back since. To find out that I made it was really exciting, and I didn't believe at first that I made all the ensembles, but I did. I was surprised.
The moment that I'm really excited is the first rehearsals. Yeah, and I realized that I was fifth stand of the first violin, and I got really surprised.
Good afternoon, everyone. Our orchestra is made up of course, music students and students from all over the university. The makeup of the orchestra is a beautiful thing, and it wouldn't work if I said you can't play if you have to miss a little bit of rehearsal. So I want everyone to be involved.
Our symphony orchestra is about 35% music majors, and then the rest are non. So it's, 65% non majors.
I am currently a junior studying mathematics with a minor in music.
I am a computer science major.
Engineering undeclared.
Computer science.
There is definitely like a part of math and music, like you gotta figure out notes and rhythms.
The analytical ability.
Being able to subdivide time.
Everybody thinks of math as a tool or the foundation of all other forms of STEM, but the way that there's this entirely different world of just numbers that doesn't really exist but exists, but it's also socially constructed is just so cool to me.
It's interesting because in the professional world, the orchestra stays the same and the conductors get rotated out. But in the academic world, the conductor stays the same and the students keep rotating out. I think here we have fantastic students and they're all going to make an impact in the world, whether it's music or not. They will at least value the arts when they're older. Hopefully what I'm doing has something to do.
I feel like I could get sappy about the experience of playing in an orchestra. There's really nothing like it.
What I really like, what I enjoy, is that challenge of getting everyone up to speed, because to me that's where the music happens. It's in the process.
There's a weird synergy between everybody where it's just like, you're no longer you, you are the symphony. It's almost like an out-of-body experience. It's so cool.